discussing about the attitude dynamics of a torque free rotating body. So, we will continue with that, and moreover if time permits then we will start with the propulsion topic. So, what last time we worked out that a rigid body is given and the body axis are coinciding with the principal axis. So, our assumption was body axis are coinciding with the principal axis. So, therefore, the off diagonal terms of inertia matrix turned out to be 0. Okay. And then we worked out the equation of motion using the Euler's dynamical equation by setting the torque in that equation to 0. Okay, so next we have what we were looking at, that a disc is given which is rotating on its axis, omega 3 is in this direction, phi dot is in this direction, and we assume here that the angular vector h is given to us, angular vector h is shown along this direction, and then psi dot also we showed along this direction, and this direction we wrote as E 3. And the final body x, because phi dot is along the body x, so this x was shown as E 3 cap, E 3 or E 3 cap, E 3 cap is the unit vector in this direction. So, similarly you can put here E 3 cap. So, we have E 1 vector in this direction, and let us say that the E 2 vector is pointing like this. So, these are the body x curve, forming the body x coordinate system. Well, this is part of the inertial reference system, and then we of course, omega vector we showed as okay, and this angle was taken as theta, and this angle was taken as gamma. So, omega was broken in the E 1 E 2 plane. So, let us consider that this is the E 1 E 2 plane. So, we broke omega in this plane and say it is lying somewhere here. Okay, so, this was termed as omega t, and it is a perpendicular omega t, and because this vector is perpendicular to the omega t, that is omega t, E 3 vector is perpendicular to the E 1 and E 2. So, the omega 3 is lying here in this place. So, this is our omega t and this is omega 3, and here our omega is lying, and h vector is coinciding along this direction. So, we assume that h is coinciding with each redirection for our convenience. This is the point O, the center of mass of the body. Okay. So, thereafter we proved that tan gamma, this is nothing but omega t divided by omega 3. So, this is your vector omega. And here in this figure is please be careful here that this vector, this is the vector here E3, and this is the actual component omega 3 which is being shown here. So, they are not appearing parallel, it is just because of this figure, but this line and this dotted line both are parallel to each other. So, omega 3 here it is appearing to go in this direction while this omega is appearing in this direction. This is not true, this should be exactly parallel to this, but once we make it parallel, so the figure does not look very good, so I have kept it like this. So, from here we can see that tan gamma, this angle is from here to here gamma, because this and this line are parallel, so this angle is your gamma. Okay, so immediately from this place you can see this value is your omega t and this is omega 3, so tan gamma is omega t by omega 3, and we already proved that omega t is a constant, omega 3 is a constant. So, this turns out to be a constant. Similarly, the tan theta, we had the, now each is the vector which is the angular momentum vector. This is the angular momentum vector. And this we can, we have broken and written as h1 e1 cap plus h2 e2 cap plus h3 e3 cap, and this was finally written as i1 omega 1 times e1 cap plus i2 omega 2 e2 cap. Just I am repeating from the last lecture, and i3 omega 3 times e3 cap. So, h becomes, now i1 and i2, they are equal to each other, and this was written as I. So, we wrote it as omega 1 e 1 cap plus omega 2 e 2 cap, and i3 was written as i 0, and the finally, this vector is nothing but omega t. So, we wrote this as the omega t times, we can write it as e t cap, which is a unit vector in the omega, this this is a unit vector. So, omega t basically we are writing as omega t times e t cap. Okay. So, this is i 0, and omega 3 is nothing but your n, okay, which is a constant. So, omega 3 equal to n, this is a constant, and omega t also we proved this is a constant. So, e 3 cap. Now, tan theta, so this is your basically h 3, and this is the tangential component, and also we last time proved that the vector omega 3 h and omega, they are lying in the same plane, and also therefore, the vector omega t, because omega t is a combination which is making here. So, omega t and omega 3, they together compose omega, okay. And omega, and we have the omega t here, and this is the vector omega whose projection is we are taking on the e 1 and e 2 plane. Now, omega, this tan theta again we wrote as see from this place, this is the h vector, and we can decompose this h vector, we can break it into two parts. So, this component will be h 3. So, here you have h 3 and this component, this is your h t. Okay. So, from here tan theta is obviously h t by h 3. So, we can write here h t by h 3, and this is nothing but your h t here. Okay. So, this h t we wrote as I times omega t, and this quantity is I 0 and omega 3, and you can see that I 0, these are constants, omega t, omega 3 are constants. So, therefore, this is also a constant. So, thus we have proved that now that gamma is a constant, because tan gamma turns out to be a constant, and similarly theta is a constant. So, this theta is a constant implies that theta dot equal to 0. Okay. Now, we can write tan theta by tan gamma from these two equations. This is, let us say this is equation number B and this is our equation number A. So, from A and B, tan theta by tan gamma becomes I omega t divided by I 0 omega 3 times divided by gamma. So, this is omega t and omega 3, this becomes I by I 0. So, this implies tan theta is equal to tan gamma times I by I 0. This is, let us say this is our equation number C. This is equation will give you very important conclusions. Now, taking this equation number C, okay, if I 0 is greater than I, okay, if I 0 is greater than I, which is the case we have been considering here, okay, we have a, suppose a big disk, okay, we are taking a big disk and it is rotating on its own axis. Okay, so, this is your phi dot shown here in this direction. So, phi dot, this is the basically the Euler rate, while omega 3 is the body rate what we have shown. So, if a big disk is rotating like this, so we can consider that this is a big disk and it is a rotating. So, this is your I 0 component we are showing in this direction, while I 1 and I 2 will be perpendicular to each other in this plane. Okay, so, obviously, in this case I 0 is greater than I. So, for the disk we have, this is the I 0 in this direction and I 1 will lie in this direction, I 2 will lie in this direction. Okay. And this is equal to I, this is equal to I. So, if I 0 is greater than I, okay, then this equation C, what does it say? The tan theta equal to tan gamma times I by I 0. So, this implies that I by I 0, this is less than 1. Okay, so, this simply implies that tan gamma will be greater than tan theta, okay, and this implies gamma will be greater than theta. So, this is the case when I 0 is greater than I. Now, take the case of a cylinder. Okay, we can discuss little bit more here before taking the case of a cylinder. we'll make a phase figure of this. This is not proper. Okay. So what we were showing here, just now we have computed this gamma is greater than theta. Gamma is the angle between, as we have seen in here in this figure, gamma is the angle between omega 3 and omega. So this is the omega vector and this is the omega 3 here. So, this is your angle from here to here, we can show as this is angle gamma. And while your theta angle is between h vector and omega 3. So, this is the h vector and this is omega 3. So, this angle is your, this is your theta. Okay, so obviously you can see that here theta is smaller than gamma, that is gamma is greater than theta. So this kind of rotation, this is called retrograde precession. What is the exact meaning of this? We will discuss it little later once we further develop the, because right now whatever the equations we have developed, it is in the terms of the body rates. And to see the, so body rates, until unless you are riding over the body itself, you won't be able to see anything. So from the, as an observer, we want to see it from the an inertial axis. So we have to get back into the equation and look at the Euler rates. So, we will try to find out the Euler rates equation and from there we will conclude the how the motion it looks like. But right now the picture is giving like this, that if I 0 is greater than I, then gamma will be greater than theta, and this is what it implies, that the omega vector will be directed like this, h vector will be directed like this and phi vector is directed like this. And this is called body cone. And this one is called space cone. This is fixed. So you can see that here, as earlier we were discussing, that the omega h and omega 3, omega vector, h vector and omega 3, they always lie in the same plane. So, what is exactly happening here? This bigger cone, this will be rolling over the space cone. Okay. So, therefore, it will be such that omega vector points inertially in the same direction, while omega and omega 3, they will be rotating, and rotating such that each always lies in the plane containing omega 3 and omega. Okay, so next we take the case of the cylinder. So, the same logic applies here also, what we have shown here in this figure, only thing the dimension changes. So, this is your omega 3, this is the center of mass of the body. Let us say this is the E1 cap and this is E2 cap, and here you have E3 cap, phi dot is in the same direction. As usual, we make H2 coincide with the E3. The H vector and the E3 cap, it is in the same direction. Okay, this is point O, let us say. Okay, now in this case is, we get back to the equation tan theta is equal to I by I 0 times tan gamma. Now, if I is greater than I 0, okay, which is the case here, this is the case of a cylinder. So, I 0 we are taking along this x, okay, while I 1 is equal to y, and here I 2 is equal to y we have taken. So, these are the principal x of the this body, this is the body of revolution. So, it is easier seeing the principal x in this case, and this is the third principal x. So, I 0 we have chosen along this direction. So, therefore, we can see that I 0 is less than I, therefore, I by I 0 this will be greater than 1, and this implies that tan theta this will be, you can see from this place that this quantity is turning out to be greater than 1, and this is to be made to equal to this quantity. So, what will happen in this case, if this quantity is less, then only if you multiply by a larger quantity this will be equal to that, and that you can see just by dividing. So, in this case tan theta will be greater than tan gamma, okay, and this implies theta is greater than gamma. And we need to fix the angles. So, the gamma we have chosen as the angle between omega vector and the omega 3. So, we need to choose all these things now carefully. Okay, so, and theta is the angle between the h and omega 3. So, as usual this is our theta angle, and gamma angle is now small. So, gamma angle, let us say in this case, this is your omega vector. Okay. So, the angle between this and this, this is your gamma. So, you can see the difference here, in this omega was located here and omega 3 here, while the h vector was located here in this place. Okay, obviously psi dot we are pointing in the same direction again. So, this vector has moved away from this position to the intermediate position between E3 and small E3 and capital E3. Okay, this kind of case we can show by our H vector is pointing in this direction. This is omega 3 E3 as usual, and here we can show this is the omega vector. So, we will have so the angle between omega 3 and omega is our gamma, this is the angle gamma. And angle between h and omega 3, this is theta. So, this is your angle from here to here, this is theta. So, the motion that we have just now depicted here, this is called direct direct precession, are also called prograde. And this refers to the case when I 0 is less than I. Okay, so the derivations till now we have done the derivations worked out are all with respect to the body X system. Which are in motion with the body. Okay. So, therefore, we do not get, a clear picture how the body is rotating in inertial space. Therefore, we need to consider the motion equation of motion in terms of Euler angles. Okay. So, this is what we are going to do. It is very clear from here that this is the angular velocity the equation that we wrote in terms of the body components of the angular velocity, this is not giving a clear picture, but it has given us some very interesting thing that these angles are constant in the case of the torque phi rotation, and moreover the and these were derived from the fact that omega 3 is a constant, and similarly we also got that omega t is a constant. So, all these are important conclusions, but we need further insight into the motion, and therefore we resort to the Euler equations. So, what we just now worked out, that tan theta, this is a constant, ok, this is very obvious, and therefore, this implies theta dot equal to 0. Earlier also we have written, ok. We will utilize this result for working out the Euler's equation. So, this was our angle psi, we rotated about this, this was angle theta, here the theta dot is there, psi dot E1 capital, E2 capital and E3 capital in this direction. So, this moved, once we rotated from here to here, this moved in this direction, and thereafter once we are giving the theta rotation, so this moves up. And the E2 comes here, this is E2 prime, it came to E2 double prime from this position to this position, and here this is E1 prime and E2 double prime, okay. And E3 prime was in the same place, and E3 this is in double prime, ok. Now, next we, once we are rotating it from here to here, so it moved from this place to this place, and this rotation was given by angle theta, ok, and thereafter we further moved it away from here to here, and this moved in the same plane as E2 double prime will move. So, it was moved from here to here by phi and here to here from phi. So, phi angle and phi angle here both. So, this is E2 triple prime, E1 triple prime, and this is E3 triple prime in the same direction, ok. So, with this figure we worked out that omega 3 is in this direction, and omega 1 is in this direction. This is omega 3, omega 1, and finally, omega 2 is here, ok. So, the equation for omega 1 we wrote as theta dot cos phi plus psi dot sin theta times sin phi. Now, just now we have seen here that theta dot equal to 0. So, this implies omega 1, this term will become 0, ok. Therefore, omega 1 becomes psi dot sin theta times sin phi, this is, let us say this is our equation number 1. Similarly, we had omega 2 equal to psi dot sin theta times cos phi minus theta dot sin phi. So, this term will become 0 here. So, this implies omega 2 is equal to psi dot sin theta times cos phi. Everywhere we are utilizing the same result, theta dot equal to 0. So, this is our equation number 2. Lastly, we have omega 3, this is equal to, this was a constant basically. So, phi dot plus psi dot cos theta is equal to n. This is a constant. Ok, this is our equation number 3. Now we differentiate equation 1, 2 and 3. So, by differentiating and thereafter we have to do some insertions here and there, after some manipulation we will be able to get to the results for theta dot, psi dot and phi dot. So, already what we have seen from this place, that theta dot equal to 0. So, this conclusion is already made, rest we will have to work out for psi dot and phi dot. Okay, so we have, now let us get back into the omega vector, which we wrote as omega t times e t cap plus omega 3 or n times e 3 cap, where omega t is a constant, omega 3 is constant. Okay, so from here certainly we can write omega square is equal to omega t square plus omega 3 square. Okay, these two are constants already proved in the last lecture. So, this implies omega square will be a constant. So, if we differentiate this, so this will be 2 times omega dot, this is equal to 0, and since omega, the magnitude of this vector which is omega, this is not equal to 0, therefore, this implies omega dot will be equal to 0. Also, we have, so by the same logic we have omega 1 square, omega 2 square, this is basically your omega t square which we have written here, this quantity, or here we write this is nothing but your omega 1 square, omega 2 square. So, we add the finally this term omega 3 square, this is basically a constant, and if you differentiate this, so this simply indicates omega 1 times omega 1 dot, omega 2 times omega 2 dot plus omega 3 times omega 3 dot, this is equal to 0. Okay, so in this equation omega 3 is a constant, already we have seen omega 3 is equal to n, this is a constant, and therefore, omega 3 dot, this will be equal to 0. So, this term will vanish. Okay, here 2 we have put, 2 we can be taken outside the bracket. So, as a whole what we are getting, so if we put omega 3 dot equal to 0, so this implies omega 1 times omega 1 dot plus omega 2 times omega 2 dot, this is equal to 0. Okay, and just now we worked out the relationship for omega 1, omega 2 and omega 3. So, these are available to us, and what we need further, this is omega 1 dot, omega 2 dot. So, omega 1 dot, we can use the equation number 1 here, omega 1 dot can be written as psi dot times, let us say the phi dot times sin theta times cos phi plus psi double dot, we are differentiating this equation here, psi double dot times sin theta times sin phi, and plus the third term we have to differentiate sin theta. So, if we differentiate this, that term will be 0, because theta dot equal to 0. So, that term we are just eliminating, this is not required here in this place. Okay. Similarly, we will have omega 2 dot, we use this equation, again the same operation we have to do here, first we have psi dot times phi dot sin theta, and this is cos phi, so this will be sin phi here now, and minus sign we put here in this place, okay, and plus psi double dot sin theta times cos phi. This is say our equation number 4, this is equation number 5. And omega 3 dot, already we have proved this quantity equal to 0. omega 3 is a constant, and omega 3 dot, this turned out to be 0. This is from the last lecture itself. So, now we have omega 1 dot and omega 2 dot available to us. So, omega 1, omega 2 also available. So, insert in this equation. So, let us write this as equation number, we have put here 4, 5, 6. So, we will term this as equation P. Putting one equations 1 to 6 in equation P, okay, so omega 1 times omega 1 dot. So, we have omega 1 is psi dot times sin theta, and then we put the omega 1 dot value. Just now we have expression we have derived, psi dot times phi dot sin theta cos phi plus psi double dot sin theta times sin phi, and plus omega 2 we have written as psi dot sin theta times cos phi, and this to be multiplied by omega 2 dot. So, omega 2 dot is minus psi dot phi dot sin theta, then sin phi, and plus psi double dot sin theta cos phi. Okay, and this is equal to 0. So, this implies omega 1 plus omega 1 dot plus omega 2 dot equal to this equal to 0. So, therefore, simplifying this, just you have to multiply and see most of the terms they cancel out, and what you get is psi times psi double dot sin square theta times sin square phi plus sin square theta times cos square phi. This is equal to 0, and this will give you psi dot times psi double dot sin square theta equal to 0. Okay. Since in general theta this is not equal to 0, so this implies psi dot times psi double dot, this is equal to 0. So, this we can write as d by d t psi dot square 1 by 2 equal to 0, and this implies psi dot square equal to 0, or ultimately we have psi dot equal to 0. Okay, psi dot square, this is a this will turn to be constant once we take the integrate it. So, after integrating we are writing as a constant. So, this psi dot becomes a constant, not 0. So, we write it on the next page. So, d by d t psi dot square equal to 0 implies psi dot square is equal to a constant, and this implies psi dot is a constant. So this is our equation number, let us say 7. So psi dot equal to a constant, this we are writing as equation number 7. So once we have got omega 1 dot, omega 2 dot, omega 3 dot, so we got all these results. So what ultimately we see that the equation for omega 1, omega 2, omega 1 dot, omega 2 dot, omega 3 dot, they will get reduced to, now omega 1 dot we can write as psi dot is a constant, and therefore psi double dot naturally this will be equal to 0. So this implies psi double dot equal to 0. So we have omega 1 dot is equal to psi dot phi dot sin theta cos phi. This is our equation number say 8. Okay. Similarly, omega 2 dot this becomes minus psi dot sin theta times sin phi. This is equation number 9, and omega 3 dot we have got as 0, and this is equation number 10. Okay. So we can see that this term and this term gets eliminated because psi double dot equal to 0. Now, earlier if you remember in the last lecture, we derived few results which were written as I times or I 1 times omega 1 dot, which was basically the reduction of the Euler's dynamical equation for the torque free case. This is what the equation we wrote the last time. Okay, so here I 1 in our case, I 1 and I 2 these are taken as equal to I, and I 3 is written as I 0. So this we wrote as I times omega 1 dot plus omega 2 times omega 3 times I 0 minus I equal to 0. Okay. This is the last time development. Now omega 1 dot is available to us, so this we name as equation number 11. So omega 1 dot is available to us, omega 2 is available, omega 3 is available, so we insert in this equation. So we insert in equation omega 1 dot from 8, equation 8, and omega 2 we have written as equation number 1 and omega 2, omega 2 and omega 3. So this is from equation number 2 and 3. Inserting equation 8, equation 2 and equation 3 in equation 11. Okay, so this will yield I times omega 1 dot, now the omega 1 dot is psi dot times phi dot sin theta times cos phi. Okay. And plus omega 2, now omega 2 we have to take again from this equation, so this is psi dot sin theta cos phi, and omega 3 this is a constant, so we simply write this as and constant, and this can be written as phi dot plus psi dot cos theta, and metals, then we have I 0 minus I. So, from this equation, let us see what we can throw out. So, sin theta cos phi, sin theta cos phi, these are on both sides, and theta this is not equal to 0 and phi also not equal to 0. So, under that circumstances what we get, okay, and psi dot is also not equal to 0. So, therefore, what we get here, I times I times phi dot plus phi dot plus psi dot cos theta times I 0 minus I, this is equal to 0. And this is equation number 12. Okay, we can break the bracket. So, this is I phi dot plus phi dot I 0 minus phi dot I plus psi dot cos theta times I 0 minus I, this is equal to 0. So, this implies this will cancel out, leaving us with psi dot equal to phi dot with a minus sign here, phi dot I 0 divided by I 0 minus I cos theta. So, you see how the equation for the Euler rates it looks like. So, this is our equation number 13. Now, this equation will give you a lot of insight how the body is rotating. So, we see that if I 0 is greater than I, then this quantity will be positive, I 0 minus I. So, I 0 minus I, this will be greater than 0. Okay. If this is greater than 0, then simply it implies that the I 0 by quantity, so this implies that I 0 by I 0 minus I, this quantity is basically greater than 0. And therefore, you can see if cos theta is positive, okay, so this term turns out to be positive. So, it says that if I 0 is greater than I, then psi dot and phi dot, they are of opposite sign. Okay. So, if psi dot, if I 0 is greater than I, then psi dot and phi dot are of opposite sign. So, you can guess what is happening here in this case. So, psi dot is basically the nodal, is the rate at which the line of node it precesses. So, you have here the case that phi dot is the on the x on which the body is rotating. So, your body is rotating like this, and psi dot we have taken along this line. So, psi dot is here and phi dot what we have shown here in that case. So, phi dot will just get reversed, okay, as the case in the figure we have shown. So, phi dot will come here in this picture. So, what it shows now here, and this is what we have termed as the retrograde motion. So, this was our retrograde motion. So, psi dot is positive, it is up, Okay, so it's a rotating like this. The precession is taking place like this. Okay, while the body rotation is like this. It's a just opposite of that. It's a body is not rotating in the same direction, but it's a rotating in the opposite direction. So basically, this vector is in this direction. Okay. So this gave us a lot of very good conclusions. Okay, so we are almost done with the attitude or of torque free rotation of a rigid body, where the body was taken as the case of body of it was basically a body of revolution. So in the next case, we will take the stability of this torque free body rotation. So this is the last part remaining. I expected to complete it today, but it's not possible. So next term we will finish the stability part, the stability of this rotating body, and then we go into the propulsion. Okay, thank you very much.